because I know about talent, because I know about artists, I managed somehow now, like a restoration, to handle these difficult things that they cannot handle. So I understand them a bit. Sometimes I'm very hard with them. Sometimes I'm very soft with them. Sometimes I'm like a dictator with them. But they do understand me because I do understand them. You know my story. I started as a restorer in Greece. I went to the Louvre. I went to the National Gallery. I did a big working for important paintings in London. But in the past, I had very good connection with Picasso, Delvaux, Magritte. I was advising Francis Bacon. Why? Because I was a technician. And artists always, they have problems with their art. And when they are contemporary, they have more problems. So I advised them how to paint. Contemporary artists, they have something in their mind.
Yes.
And they would, let's say some of them, they want to use the newspapers. But newspapers, they're not meant to be last forever.
Yes.
A restorer could advise them how it could last longer. Picasso, for instance, he has problems with cracking his paintings because he used a lot of paste in the late ones. And when you use a lot of paste and a lot of colors, it cracks. So you have to have a special medium to do the work. Now we are almost like an institution. I have a license to deal in antiquities and icons, which is an official license in Greece. With me, you could find things from the beginning of Greek time until today. Greece is a love affair. Greeks, they're like me. They're made from old and new materials. People, they come here because, honestly, I think it's one of the realest places on earth now. Greeks, they have no reason to change. And they change gradually and slowly. We have the chromosomes of great people. Greece is a motherland, and you have to walk on the ground to get energy. Greece export art from the beginning of time. 2,500 years ago, they export letters, they export music, they export sculptures, they export paintings, and all the rest of the world was buying this production of Greece. Art is talent. Talent is spirit. What they use? They use oxidized colors, just powder colors. So this man, he was got the gift from God, whoever God is for everybody, to be able to transform this simple, inexpensive material to something moving, something acceptable by everybody. Something that could change the world. So the molecule of that is art. Art is very powerful. It's like a volcano. It will sit and sleep for a long time, but eventually will erupt. When I was young, and I did the perfection of man in Belgium. It means analysis of pigments, analysis of everything, trying to find the fakes and my idea was how this will be created. Why should I sit in the front of a painting and I feel small? Or, a good example, when you listen Pavarotti or Callas,
yes.
If you are an artist, first of all, you feel angry. Why? Because God, he could tell you that you don't have the talent. So you are a little bit like Salieri. He thought he was the representative of the God on that particular time on music. And eventually, one day, Mozart's wife brought him and said, what is this? How many times, he said, he written this? Say, I'm sorry, he said, it's not written, it's just first. So he realized that God has cheated him. That the talent, it was Mozart. The talent, it is something that it doesn't make any difference who's got it. Maybe he looks outside ugly. Maybe he looks outside dirty. Maybe he's an individual. And most of them, you see, they are not accepted by society. But what they've got God's gift to transform things. Art, it is the only thing it could last. Art is the only thing that the civilized people, cultures, countries, they will do after they feed the hunger. After you have filled the hunger for your body, you have to do something for your soul. The only close thing to the world we live in, it's art, and it's very, very powerful. I'm trying all my life to understand. When I was young, I worked with somebody who was Swedish with electronic microscopes. Mm. What I wanted to do, to take a sample, like a urine, like a blood,
yes,
from an artist,
yes,
put it on a microscope, put a computer, and it will tell me the computer if this man has got it or not.
Yeah, but
it doesn't work. If a blacksmith takes a piece of steel,
yes,
and he's making a horse, I don't know, something for the horse, steel, this steel has been changed. He put some of his own self within it. This is material and he gave it spirit. So in other words, people, they somehow don't understand that art is not a simple matter. People, they're simple. Countries, they're simple. Politicians, they're simple. All this is simple. It's predictable. You know exactly what happened. You put analyze, you put in the computer. Try to put in the computer art. Try to tell me who's got the talent and why.
Sure.
Tell me why somebody who is so mean, like, I don't know, like Getty. I work for the greatest of the people. Getty, Livanos, Niarchos, Dugin, many people, many bigger. Why? I was a restorer and they had things to restore. But they were, he was very mean. When he died, you know what he did? He gave everything to art. Because he was feeling maybe sorry and he wants to have immortality.
Yes.
He wants to have immortality.
He did. Yes.
How he got immortality? Because he had oil? Because he has money? No, because he created a museum. It's incredible. I mean, art is powerful.
What is the modern incarnation of what an icon was 2,000 years ago?
Like a language.
Language?
It is like a language.
Uh-huh.
It's like letters. The Greek alphabet has got 24 letters. Mm-hmm. With these 24 letters, you could do anything you want. You could write a bad letter, you could write a good letter, you could write a love letter, you could write a poem, mm-hmm, you could write history, you could do philosophy, you could write music, anything with letters.
Sure.
Art, in fact, it is that. It hasn't been finished yet. Henry Moore,
okay,
the greatest of all sculptors in England. He had an exhibition and he said in 1960 that Greek art is dead. All this Greek art, Praxiteles and this and that, and they're all dead. I mean, we have a new thing now. Now we're doing modern things. We don't have to... Why should we go back to all these bodies and this and that? In 1975 I met him because his wife was Russian and they had a couple of icons in the house. So I met his daughter, she was very pretty, and she said, come to meet my father. He was a big man anymore. He was as big as Picasso alive, all right? So I went there and I saw this fantastic man, who was a monument, and we became friends. And he said to me, I have to tell you, he was around late 70s, I have to tell you how sorry I am, because I have said this in 1960. I said that Greek art is dead. Now I realize, now I'm almost 80 years old, I have achieved fame, I am a big artist, and I realize that I could never achieve this perfection. In other words, when you look at Greek sculpture, you have to look at microphotography of it. You're gonna look at great painting, you have to look at microphotography of it. It means 1/1,000,000th or the surface.
Sure.
That's where the perfection is. And Harry Moore realized that a lot of his sculptures, they didn't have this perfection.